Hey there and welcome back to another PSD Tuts Spoon-Fed Photoshop Tutorial screencast. I'm Gavin Steele, and in today's screencast I'm going to be taking you through Constantin's Creating an Out-of-the-Bounds Fantasy Illustration. And I'm just going to show you the final image. So this is the kind of thing that we're going to be aiming for with the tutorial. Do check out the original by Constantin. There's some great links, some great tips and stuff on how you create the final image. Little tweaks here, tells you how to play around with different things. And obviously takes you through step by step how you create that great image. There is one just little thing I just want to point out. He does make use of a bit of software that I used to have on a 30-day trial, something like that. This Topaz Labs. Unfortunately, my 30-day trials run out, so I won't be able to do that part of the tutorial. But I will get as close and hopefully creating a pretty cool image along the way. So that's what we're aiming for. Do check out the extensive links, if I just bring that back down so you can see how many we're going to be using today. Some of them free, some of them over at DeviantArt. Make sure you check out the user's work and leave a comment, something like that. Let them know how you're using it or how you plan to use it. And we've got lots and lots of images that we're going to be using in today's screencast, so I'm just going to quickly flick through a few of them. Some nice waterfall, some textures, and an eagle or a hawk, golf ball, the dark room that we're going to start with, some more textures, and there's a quick link to the Topaz Labs plugin for Photoshop. Can see it's pretty cool. So yeah, that's the tutorial. So I'm going to take us through that right now. Let's just take this back up to the top. Okay, so the first thing I'm just going to show you is, you know, where I got up to with mine. Just zoom in. You know, we've got a great frame there with the picture in the background, the water coming down. We've got this mandolin, the eagle or the hawk breaking out of the cage. And it's kind of abstract, but it's a pretty cool image. And let's get started. So I'm going to close that down there. And let's load up. The first image you're going to need is our room. So let's just bring that in. Apologies for my voice. I'm getting a bit of a cold, unfortunately. So let's just zoom out and make sure we can see that. Okay. So we're starting with the old dark room. Import it straight in there, resize it if you want a bigger canvas or a smaller canvas, get it just right. And then what we're going to do is we're going to bring in a vintage grunge texture and we're going to resize that. So here's my vintage grunge texture. V on the keyboard to select the move tool. And I'm just going to drag that straight onto our canvas. Command T to scale, to transform. I'm going to lock the ratio and just bring that down a bit and kind of position that into place like so. That looks pretty good, and then hit enter. Okay, then what we're going to do is we're going to set that to multiply. Okay, and we're going to use the eraser tool and we're going to get rid of some of these edges. So hit E on the keyboard, nice big brush. Actually, make sure you've got a nice soft brush. And let's just reduce the opacity down just a bit and increase that brush size. And we're just going to go along the top up here, down the sides. Like so. Just blending that in. Pretty good. Let's just zoom in, have a look. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay. So once you've erased and you've blended in a little bit, hit O on the keyboard, head over to your burn tool, and we're just going to burn these areas that we've added, these dark patches, and I'm going to select the shadows and exposure's down to about 10%, just so we can build it up as we go along and just hit that up a little bit like so, and they'll just come out, just stand out that little bit more. And just rubbing over each of these, just so they stand out that little bit more. Excuse me. Okay, next thing to do, Command Shift U on the keyboard. That's just going to desaturate that. And again, using the burn tool, if some of these are just faded out that little bit too much, let's just bring them back with the burn tool. Like so, but that looks pretty good. It's adding an extra bit of texture to that wall. Just kind of makes it look, you know, that little bit better. It's all these little bits of detail that Constantin throws in there that create some really great images. Okay, the next thing we're going to move on to is importing our frame. So make sure you cut your frame out. I've already done mine here, you can see. If I turn that back on, there's the original. There's the cutout. So again, V on the keyboard to move it. Just going to drop it straight in. Command T to transform it. Lock this. Reduce it in size. Let's bring it up. And I'm going to flip that right down across like so. Move it up to the top and then just hit enter. And we're going to play around with this. We're going to make it a little bit wider. We're going to do some cloning and so on. So the first thing I need to do is just grab the selection tool and we're going to select this half. And copy that onto a new layer and grab the other half. Make sure you got the right layer selected. Copy that and paste that onto a new layer. Can turn this one off, and we just got a little bit of a break. That doesn't matter because we're going to be playing around with it anyway. So hit V on the keyboard, and we're going to move this one just to the right. Like so. Brilliant. Okay. We're going to have a look at cloning these areas across just to fill in this gap. So we're going to zoom in just a little bit. Like so. And again, we're going to go back to our selection tool and we're just going to select the part of the panel like this. I'm going to copy that, make sure I'm on the right layer. Copy that, stick that on a new layer. And then V, I'm just going to move it to the right. So you can see we've just created a copy of that layer. If I hold down Shift, it'll stay in line, hopefully, like so. And then I'm going to hold down Alt, which is going to create a copy of that layer, and then Shift again, and just keep doing that until we get a nice little join. Looks pretty good. Now, we're going to merge this a little bit later on, and we're going to clone out any of these harsh lines, but for now that's pretty good. Z on the keyboard, and then click to zoom back out, and now we're going to work on this area down the bottom. Okay, so make sure you've got the bottom half selected, and again, we're just going to select this little area here, copy, stick that onto a new layer, and then move that across, hold down Alt. Okay, looks pretty good. Next thing to do, select all of those layers, Shift, Command E or Control E, merge them together, and we can start to clone. That's all one piece now, so it all moves together. So, S on the keyboard to go to your clone tool, Alt, click where you want to actually select to start copying from, and then just start painting over it. It's a little bit fidgety with all these lines, but you will get there. Quite a lot of noise outside today. Okay, move that up. It doesn't have to be exact because we're going to break this up anyway and we're going to, you know, do lots of effects to it, but just, you know, as best as you can get it for now. That looks pretty good. Let's head up to the top. And again, Alt to select. Some are a little bit more obvious than others. Okay, let's zoom out and let's have a look. Brilliant, so that looks great. No clear sign that they've been joined together, but obviously if we had a closer look, we can see that it has been. And we'll just zoom out, Command T now, and we'll position that. There we go, looks pretty good. And we're just gonna shrink that down just a little bit, it's a little bit big. And that looks pretty good. And then just hit on enter. Okay, so we're gonna apply a couple of adjustments to our frame. Head up to Hue and Saturation. In your adjustments panel, hue and saturation, and we're going to set this to hue of minus 25, minus 60 for the saturation, and 0 for our lightness. Click on OK. Then we're going to head over to our levels, and we're going to set this to 17. 1 and 255, and then finally if you've got vibrance on Photoshop CS4, hit that up, or go back into your hue and saturation and we'll just bring that down again. Now a lot of this tutorial is going to be applying different effects and having a look at the preview to see the result that you get to try and tie things into the overall look of the room. So again, I'm just going to bring my saturation down. Kind of still want to keep the purpliness of it, but minus 10 looks pretty good. Okay, for now, that's pretty good. So that's our frame. The next thing we need to do is go grab our cracked texture and apply it to our frame. So let me go grab that. Here we go. And again, just going to drag that straight onto our frame. I'm going to come down here to the quick mask tool, or just the mask tool, sorry. Select that. Actually, before I do that, I'm going to command click on my frame and then hit the mask, and it'll apply that automatically to that image. And then we can come up to multiply, and you can just reduce the opacity down just a bit. Just give you an idea of what we just did. A really nice, quick and easy way to apply textures to things. If you don't want to use multiply, if it's too harsh, you can click on overlay and then reduce your opacity down 50% or so, but for this one I think it works if you set it to multiply. Just brings a bit of definition to those cracks. And again, we're gonna Command J to duplicate that twice, and then I'm going to reduce the opacity on each of these. Again, looking at the final result to see how that pays off. Select all three, and then we're going to merge all of those together. Come on, we don't need to merge them. We can leave that like so. Okay, it looks pretty good. Next thing I'm going to do is we're going to import our C image and we're going to stick it behind our frame. So load up the C image and we don't need to cut it out, we're just going to drag that straight onto our document. So again, that goes right on there. Command T to scale it, lock the ratio, that right down. We're just going to angle it just a little bit. And let's bring that below our frame so we can get a better idea of how everything's going to look. Okay, probably just going to angle that, just bring that back just a little bit. Okay, looks pretty good. And then again, select, command click just on our frame layer, come back to our C layer, and we can just, in fact, we're not going to do that at all. We're going to do what I'm meant to do, and that is we're going to mask out this area. So click on the mask, B for brush, bring the size of the brush right down, make sure it's nice and hard. And we're just going to mask out, just in case we got any around the edges, like so. Excuse me. So that's our C in there. We're going to apply some adjustments to that layer as well, and just the same way. So all of those can be found, all these settings. If we make sure we select the actual image layer and not the mask, we head up to Image, Adjustments, and we come down to Exposure. We're going to set that to 1.0. And we're going to go back to Image and Adjustments, and we're going to come down to Color Balance, and we're going to set that to minus 10. And click on OK. In fact, that's a little bit too much there. So let's just click on that one more time. Image Adjustments, and what did I set? Oh, that's right, minus one. That's better. So I made that a little bit too light. So I've just darkened that a little bit, and we head back up to Image, Adjustments, down to Color Balance. And again, we can set that to minus 10. And they're just really, you know, simple little adjustments that just make that image just look a little bit more realistic in the background or in the actual frame itself. Okay, once we've done that, I've gotten rid of a couple of those, layers that we didn't need. And I'm just going to grab those two, this layer, Command-E, and we're just going to merge them together. So now that's one image. And if we just zoom out, we're going to distort this now. So Command-T to transform, right-click, and we're going to come to Distort. And we're going to grab this right handle, like so. I'm going to drag that right out. I'm going to bring this one up just a bit. Bring this one down. Yep, that looks pretty good. And then we're going to hit enter. Okay, so that's starting to add to the actual abstract look and feel of the whole image. Next thing we need to do is import our couch. Okay, and again, I've already gone around with the pen tool, and I've cut that couch out. It takes a little bit of time, but once you get good with the pen tool, you can just nip around that really quickly. Stick that straight into our image, and Z, let's zoom out and make sure we get the positioning of this absolutely right. So we're going to put it back just a bit, like so. And we're going to apply a couple of effects to this, and then we're going to distort this one as well to make it look again like it's bending into our black hole kind of thing, which is going to appear there. So once you've got your couch in, we're going to do some color correction. We're going to head up to levels, so Command L on your keyboard. Set that first to 17. We're then going to do exposure, so back up to image, adjustments, and exposure. We're going to set that to minus 0.50, and then we're going to hit our hue and saturation, we're going to set our saturation to minus 60. And I'm just going to pull my hue and saturation down just a touch, just so I can see exactly how that image is looking and how it's starting to fit into the background. So if I increase that saturation, desaturation, how is that image going to look? How much of the color am I keeping? And so on. So we just want a hint of this orange, a hint of the cushions coming through, but we don't want it to, you know, to stand out, to be too gold in that particular room. So about minus 60, you've gone up to minus 67 there, that's fine. And click on OK. And then we're going to hit the curves, so Command M on your keyboard, that'll bring up your curves. And again, just going to try and position this so we can see enough of the couch and play around with the curve, so you can make it slightly darker to bring out a bit of the detail in our couch. That looks pretty good. Touch lighter, touch darker. No, somewhere about there. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Saves us on some burning later on. Click on OK. Then we're going to duplicate, Command J on the keyboard, Command Shift U to desaturate, or you could have head up to Image Adjustments and then desaturate. There it is. Make sure you see, you should be starting to learn these shortcuts on the keyboard because it just makes life a lot easier. And then we're going to basically change the opacity down to about 29%, something like that. Again, looking at the image as we reduce the opacity to see what effect it's going to have. So I think I set that to about 29. Yeah, we keep a lot of the little gold bits here, but it also desaturated that a little bit. Okay, so we're going to command click on our couch now to get our actual shape. And then we're going to go to our brush tool. So let's hit enter on that. Come to our brush tool, B on the keyboard. And we're going to start to paint in some black edges. Okay, so again, we need a big soft brush and bring that down. And we're just going to go around the edges of our couch to add a bit of shadow, a bit of shape to it. So make sure you've got black selected and just coming around these areas here. Doesn't seem like much now, but if I command deselect, you see we get a bit more of the shape, a bit more shadowing, a bit more of the light reflection, stuff like that. And in fact, just gonna undo that. Let's do that on its own layer. Grab a new layer and let's just whisk around the edges like so, and then reduce the opacity right down, and then desaturate. And if you feel like you've done too much, grab the eraser tool and you can just peel back some of the darkness. Okay, next thing we need to do is create a new layer below the couch layer. So let's do that now. And on this layer, we're going to be adding our shadow underneath. So again, use the same black brush that you've got, and we're going to paint the shadow underneath. So if I just zoom in, just so we get a nice idea where our shadow is going to be. And with that brush, just going to paint underneath here, like so. Again, grab the eraser tool if you think you've come a little bit too far. Okay, that looks pretty good. And we're going to reduce the opacity back down as well. Again, until it looks like an actual shadow. Now, you'd probably be able to see the back of the wall. We don't need to worry because we're going to add our water effect there, but that looks pretty good. In fact, I'm just going to select all of my couch stuff and V on the keyboard, and then I'm just going to nudge it to the left. And then I'm going to zoom out. And let's have a look at the overall composition now. I'm pretty happy with the positioning of the frame itself. I think my couch is a little bit too big. So I'm just going to stick everything into a folder. And I'm going to call that couch. And Command T, transform everything in there. And I'm just going to bring it all down just a bit. Yeah. That looks better. Let's have a little zoom in. Yeah, that looks much better. Okay, so back to that shadow layer down here. Normal brush. That looks pretty good. I'm going to add just a little bit of this shadow. Just coming up the wall behind. I hope that comes out on the screencast, but just a little nudge just to try and add a bit of depth to behind the couch. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we're going to apply some burning. So O on the keyboard, we'll head over to the burn tool. And we're going to darken these areas on the couch. So where the cushion sits, we're just going to darken those areas. So make sure you've got the couch selected. And just come in here, just darken these. A little patch there. Just to bring out those, you know, those areas to make it look like it's been sat on, make it look like it's been lived on. And that's pretty much it. I mean, we're going to merge the tool, the couch now, all those layers. So click on that folder. In fact, I'm going to duplicate it. This is what I tend to do. Duplicate the layer, turn off the original, Command D, and merge the new one. So at least you've got a backup, you know, if you ever want to come back to it. So once you've merged it, let's zoom out. And we're going to Command T, transform that layer, and we're going to start by distorting it, and we're going to bring this front leg out. Let's see. Yeah, to about there. Bring that over and hit return. Now it doesn't matter at this point if it looks too crazy, because you know we're going for that kind of abstract look of, you know, something in the middle of this image is warping the image, so we want it to look a little bit odd, so people are a bit like, whoa, you know, why is this side a little bit more blown up than this side, you know, what's going on with the picture frame and so on. So once we've done that, that's all done, we're going to head over to a new layer, and we're going to grab our brush tool, and in fact, we're going to touch up these areas on the wall. So again, back with your brush tool, I'm going to bring it below my couch layer, and just going to add a bit more shadow now to this wall, now that we've moved it. And again, bring the opacity right down, like so. All right, let's add some of this water now. Okay, so let's load up our waterfall. And I'm going to take you through how we're going to create some of this. Now, I'm not going to do all of it, but I'm going to take you through how you do each little bit and then come back with a bit of it done. But you'll be able to pick it up straight away. It's a pretty cool technique. So we're going to select a bit of waterfall. So I'm going to start with something like so. And holding Command down on the keyboard, I'm just going to drag that straight into our piece, and I'm going to scale it right down. And then V to position it, and this bit's going to be breaking over. the edge just there. Okay, so as you bring in each piece, and you've got to do it bit by bit, picking out parts of the waterfall, we're going to make sure that we go through all the same settings. So the first thing we need to do is Command Shift U, and we're going to desaturate it. Then we're going to set it to a blending mode of lighten. Okay, and then reduce the opacity down to about 80%, or as you start to build it up, to just the amount that you need. Now, when you're positioning these, you can use Command T and then the warp, and we can just start to play around with how these are going to blend or move down the actual image itself. And then zoom in, grab the eraser tool, nice soft brush, lower the opacity right down, just get rid of these sharp edges. So, spacebar to move around the screen while you're using a tool. That's it, don't worry about it. It is a long process. We're going to be building this up. And slowly but surely. Okay, and then we just zoom out and have a look. Okay, it's starting to look pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to add a few more bits, come back, and then we'll just finish it off, okay? And with the waterfall almost finished, I'm going to take you through some of the last little bits. Now, head back to your waterfall slice. Let's grab this slice tool, and I'm going to fill in this area down here in the middle. I want to give another little strand to down here. So I'm going to select, I'm going to zoom in and grab my lasso tool, and we're going to select this area here. Again, move it down, Command on the keyboard, and then just drag that straight onto our new document. V to move it into place, Command T to scale it. Gonna bring that right down. And that's the kind of area that we're aiming for. Then remember Command Shift U to desaturate, set it to lighten, reduce the opacity right down, maybe 70 for this one. Hit enter. And then just going to zoom in and get our positioning right. Okay, V on the keyboard. And let's have a look. So we kind of want to keep this little line going across, which kind of lines up with that. That looks pretty good. And then E on the keyboard for the eraser. And we're going to do a lot of work just erasing this area down here just to get it to blend. Just cut that away like so. And that, you know, it's a great little technique for just, you know, adding a really cool water effect. You could have this, you know, the waterfall coming in from through the door, through a window in the door, out of an eye, you know, anything you want. It's a great little technique. Okay, so what I was looking for there, when I'm, you know, lining this up, is see the line of the couch underneath. I'm trying to get maybe to look like the water's come over, built up, and then, you know, kind of burst its banks kind of thing before it's got down here to the bottom. And again, you just start to thin out this area here, reduce the opacity down a bit. Okay, Zed, zoom out. Let's have a look at how that looks. That looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. Kind of looks like there's a bit of water come over and then built and then burst to the left, I guess. Again, you can play around with that all day. Let's minimize our water. And let's have a look at the picture as a whole and see what we need to add next. Next thing that we're probably going to add is the water coming down along the bottom down here towards the screen and towards you, the viewer. So let's just zoom out one more time. Okay, so to do that, next thing we need to do is grab our next water image, which is this one here. Again, V on the keyboard, drag that straight in, Command T to scale it, keep the proportion, and let's drag that down. Take that in place, and Z to zoom in, let's have a look. Okay, so once you've got this new image in, the first thing to do is desaturate, Command-Shift-U will desaturate for you, and then we've got to think about perspective. So Command-T, how is this going to look coming towards us? Hit perspective, and then we're just going to play around with. Let me just zoom out just a little bit more. Okay. Command T, hit perspective. A bit fidgety. There we go. So bring it out towards us. Let's move it down. Hit enter, and then we can just start to position that like so, and then zoom in. Let's have a look at how that's going to look. Okay, I'm not happy with that, so let's just zoom out. Let's have a look. Command T. Back to perspective, and it is just, you know, playing around with it. Okay, it looks a little bit better. Well, let's set it to screen, and we're gonna reduce that down to about, let's say, 60%. Okay, grab the eraser tool, and again, let's increase that up to about 30, something like that. Nice big brush. And let's just take out these hard edges behind. Okay, let's have a look at how that's looking. That looks pretty good. Okay, again with the eraser tool, just going to pick up these edges, come in a little bit down the side because the flow of water is a little bit unpredictable, but that looks pretty good. Okay, and then let's just zoom out. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. This area just down here, actually, I'm missing a bit of water that I brought in. Now, clearly, if you label all of your layers correctly, there we go. Right down the bottom here. Let's bring that up to the top, underneath our waterfall. And it's just a little bit of a join between the two. And again, you know, taking an image like this, you get lots of areas. Like at the bottom down here and along here that you can build up to create this area down at the bottom. And again, it just adds, I think it looks pretty good. Okay, let's minimize that and let's move on to our mandolin, which is going to sit on this right hand side of the image. Open up the mandolin image. I've got mine already open and I've already cut mine out again. Took a little bit of time. It's not perfect, but I think for the tutorial it's pretty good. And I'm just going to drag that layer straight on. Command T. Let's scale that. Whoops. Just make sure we click that. And let's bring that down. Place that over the couch. Now it's meant to look like it's just floating. It's pretty good positioning. And let's hit enter. Okay, so we've got our mandolin on there. First thing we need to do is duplicate it. So Command J on the keyboard. And with that new one, we're going to select our blending options and going to select color overlay, select that to black, click on OK and OK. And then we're going to bring that down below the original layer. I'm just going to turn off auto select and we're going to place this over our couch like so. Command T, hit the warp tool. And we're going to just bend the arm just a little bit so it's bending with the couch. Yep, that looks pretty good. And we're going to flatten the top part like so. Let's enter, that looks pretty good. Okay, so once you've done that and we've set it up, we need to set it up to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. And we're going to set that to 3 is probably just about right, actually. Let's hit 3 and set it to overlay. And let's reduce the opacity right down to something like 60% or something like that. Okay, looks pretty good. Grab your eraser tool. We're going to take off the end down here. Pretty good. I guess the shadow would fall down around here, but for now that's pretty good. Okay, so we need to do a bit of editing on the actual mandolin layer, which is this layer 11. So we're going to play around with the color and so on. So let's head up to image and adjustments and let's go to brightness and contrast. And let's do brightness of minus 26 and the contrast of minus 8. Let's click on OK. And then let's go to image and hue and saturation and we'll set that to a saturation of minus 44. Let's click on OK. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay, so we're up to step 11 on the original tutorial. We need to grab one of our pedestals now, and we're going to stick... Oh, sorry, that keeps happening. I've just got a second monitor put in, and all of my spaces and exposés and things are all a bit messed up. Okay, so we're going to add in a couple of pedestals now. And to do that, you need to head over to the pedestal image, like so. And I've already, again, gone around with the pen tool, just selecting each of those. And this is the first one we're going to bring in, this one on the left. Again, just drag that layer straight in, Command-T, bring it right down. And we're going to position this back here and behind our couch, like so. Now again, it's a little bit big, so Command T, I'm just going to scale and bring this down just a bit. And then I'm just going to bring down the top. Like so, looks pretty good. Okay, we're going to apply again more color stuff. Again, looking at it, seeing how it's going to fit into the rest of the image, the rest of the piece. We need to darken it. So again, grab the burn tool. Let's just burn across the top up here. Come down the sides. Down the bottom looks pretty good. Let's duplicate that layer. Let's desaturate that. Change the blending mode to multiply. And then let's reduce the opacity. Again, looking how does that fit into the overall image. I think that's pretty good over at 62%. And let's grab our cracked image. In fact, I think that's still open. There we go. Again, we're going to bring that straight on to that layer. Going to select that layer. Like so, mask out our cracking, and I'm just going to go back one step, select that layer, and transform this down so we get some tighter cracks, bring it round, that's probably better. Command click on the layer to make a selection of it, and then where have I just put that? Oh, I've lost that cracked layer. Oh no, there we go. So make that a selection and then block that out. And again, let me just bring that back. Transform, bring it around, and scale that down. Okay, it's pretty hard to see on the thumbnail over here. I did have it. Select that layer and mask that out. Okay, so with that cracked layer, Command-Shift-U to desaturate it. Set it to multiply and then just reduce the opacity just a bit. So let's zoom in so we can have a really good look at how that looks. And that looks pretty good. If we reduce opacity too much, we're not going to see those cracks. And we're at 200% here. Let's zoom out to 100. We want to be able to see the cracks at 100%. And to be honest, that looks pretty good. It kind of blends in with the background as well. So I'm happy with that. Second pedestal now. Head back over to our pedestal image. Pick that up. Turn this one off. Grab that layer. I'm going to stick it in. Command T. Let's scale that right down, enter, zoom out, and we're going to stick this one over to the left, and we're going to have it just coming in from over the right here, like so. And again, we're going to play around with the colors on that. So O back to color burn, nice big brush. And let's just darken some of these details down here. Okay. And then we're going to head up to saturation again, image adjustments and hue and saturation. And again, bring our saturation down just a little bit. Get image adjustments, brightness and contrast. Okay, you want this a little bit brighter because it's closer to us. Let's click on OK. Let's Command J, duplicate that layer. Command-Shift-U to desaturate. Let's set it to multiply and reduce the opacity right down to about 40. That looks good. Okay, so grab that crack texture one more time. take it over like so. Let's select that pedestal, mask that out, desaturate, set it to multiply, zoom in to at least 100%, and that looks pretty nice. Now again, have a play around, reduce the opacity down. Are those cracks too strong for you? Maybe you only want slight cracking. I think that's pretty good. A little marbled effect. And let's zoom back out. Okay, like so. Right, we're going to move on now to the birdcage. And let's load that up. Okay. And again, I've already cut out my birdcage. I did not use the pen tool this time. I used one of the channel methods where you select the channel and increase contrast and so on. There's loads of tutorials on PSD Tuts about making selections like that. And I'm just going to bring that straight in. Command T to scale it. And we're going to bring that right down. Even a little bit smaller than that. But a bit bigger than that. So let's try 14. 16 looks pretty good. Let's get that swinging. So we're going to bring that back. Bring it up to the top. And hit enter. Okay, so once you've got that in place, we're going to duplicate it. So Command J on the keyboard. Back into our blending options. Color overlay. Set it to black. Click on OK and OK. And then that duplicate layer we're going to reduce down to 50%. Okay, and our original layer, just below it, we're going to reduce that down to somewhere in the 80s, I think. Let's see, 85. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Let's zoom in. And check that out. So that's at 100%. And yeah, it looks pretty good. So again, the cutout isn't perfect. You spend a bit more time. But when you're going through a tutorial, it's about learning techniques, not necessarily about getting the image exactly how, you know, Constantin set it out. It's about thinking about how you can apply these to your own images. So that looks pretty good. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to cut out a makeshift door. So let's just zoom out, bring this over. Okay. Grab the pen tool. And we're just going to grab a rough idea. Of a door. Right, that's not going to work. So I need to give myself lots of room. Pen tool. Fix this up afterwards, I just need to make sure. Oh, I see. Okay, that looks pretty good. Right click inside once you've made your selection of that panel, and we're going to make it a selection. Zero for your feather, click on OK, and we're going to copy that. Going to create a new layer, bring it underneath the original, going to paste that in. I don't know what that is or why it's copied. Okay, V, and we're going to move to the left, and we have ourselves a makeshift door. Now let's zoom in and play around. Now this isn't, it isn't perfect. You know, we've got, it kind of looks 3D with that image down in the bottom. But again, let's Command J to duplicate it. Gradient, color overlay. Make sure that's set to black. Reduce the opacity down. And we can reduce the opacity of the original just a bit because it is further away from the rest of the door. And then we can just, again, grab those two layers, merge them together, and we can skew these about. Grab the eraser tool. It looks a little bit short there. So let's transform it. Again, let's skew it. We're trying to get this little beam up. Yep, that looks much better. Okay, so it kind of looks like the door that's opened for the birdcage, but obviously, you know, if you had more time, you'd take out some of these little strands in here and not make it look like there's another box behind there. But if you zoom out, it does a really good job of looking like it's the birdcage that's been opened. And, you know, that's pretty nice quick method of doing that. Okay, so once you've done that, you've cut it out, you've multiplied it. Next thing that we need to do is add our bird. So to add our bird, we need to load up our image. Again, I've cut this out from the original image here, and I'm just going to drag that straight on. And we're going to position it between the cage and our frame, scale it. We're going to flip that and then just bring it round down and then scale it right down. Then we can zoom back in. Let me just fix the size of my window here. So that's it at 100%. And the position's pretty good. It's aiming for the real world through the window, as Constantin says, escaping from the cage. So, excuse me, with our bird in, we're going to duplicate it. So Command J. And then we're going to double click on that layer, color overlay, select black. Again, bring it down below our original. And now we need to think about, where is this shadow going to sit? So bring it right down onto our couch. Okay, you can see, unfortunately, it sits behind the couch. So we're going to grab these two layers now, and we're going to bring them above our couch layer. Yep, that looks pretty good. Okay, so whereabouts on the couch is this going to hit? Let's say it's going to cover that area there, come down a bit. Yep, that looks pretty good. And I'm just going to move them up above the waterfall as well, because that doesn't make sense. fact, let's move them right up here to the top. Okay, so with our shadow layer selected, we're going to do exactly the same as we did before. Head up to Gaussian Blur, Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Yep, 3 pixels looks pretty good to me. Click on OK and then just reduce the opacity down until it looks like it fits in to our image, which it does. Now I think the shadow would probably hit that and fall behind the couch, so I'm going to grab my eraser tool and I'm just going to get rid of that just ever so slightly. But that looks pretty good. Okay, so we need to play around with the color of our bird. So Command M to bring up curves, and again making sure I can see my bird. Just gonna play around with it ever so slightly, like so. Again, zoom back into 100%, see what it looks like. That looks pretty good. Okay, so now it is time to start to break up the images and the items, so it looks like it's all kind of breaking apart, the surreal world. And to do that, we're going to use a really simple technique. Okay, we're going to use our lasso tool and we're going to circle a little bit and we're going to pull them apart. Then we're going to grab some of the brushes that you may have downloaded, the grunge brushes and so on, and we're going to like interlace those with the actual items breaking up to create a really cool effect. And we just need to select each layer at a time. So we're going to start with our frame layer here, which I've zoomed into 1,000,000% there. Okay. And we're going to use V to select our move tool. We're going to turn auto select on and then click on that layer to make sure we've got that layer. And then you're going to come over to the lasso tool, which is L. So if you know those keyboard shortcuts, you're going to be able to work with this really well. So how are we going to break this up? Well, we're going to start by just grabbing a little area like that, hold down Command and just move it. That's it, just little movements to start with. This will just take a couple of seconds, move around the top. Just move down there, and you're pretty much going to go through the same process for each actual item as you go along. So we're going to come down this side here, and when we get to the bird, we're going to apply a couple of brushes as well. You're not moving some of the big pieces quite as far, just enough to give the impression that it's all kind of crumbling and falling apart. Okay, let's move down the bottom here and let's have a look at our guitar. Again, V, select the item you want to edit, L for lasso tool, grab a section, Command, just move it up a little bit. It's also a good idea to zoom in. Again, L back to our lasso tool, grab a little bit of that, just move it. Okay, so that's our guitar area done. Maybe get some of these little bits of black. Oh. And you get better at this over time, and you know, you get a real nice rhythm going as you build it up. Let's come down to this area down here. Again, let's just grab that. You know what's happened to my guitar? It's grumbling. Okay, that looks pretty good. Maybe have some of these bits just down here, breaking off down towards the bottom. Like so. And then last little bit over here. Again, V on the keyboard, select this big guy, and right, so how are we going to grab this after we've made all of these layers? If I just show you which layers we've got, that 1, 2, 3 and so on. If I grab those three and we command D, merge them, we get this weird little outline here that I'm not happy with. So one way of doing it is creating a new layer, go to image and apply the image. Let's not do that. Let's come back up to the top, new layer, image, and why is that not working? Well, one way would have been to apply the whole image and then just selecting that area and leaving it in. And I'm not sure why it's not allowing us to do that. Nope, doesn't want to let me do it. So delete that for now. Okay, well, leave that for now. I'll try and figure out why that's not working in a second, but we need to move on and have a look at our bird, and we're going to start to play around with breaking up our bird. So zoom right into the bird, like so. Again, lasso tool after you've selected your bird layer. Okay, L for lasso, and just start breaking this up. Nice small little bits, small little movements. You'll get a really cool effect. Move around. Okay, and let's zoom back. That looks pretty good. Now, what we're going to do with the bird is, if we zoom out, we're going to grab a brush tool, so B, head up to our brushes, and we're going to try and find a brush that's kind of splashy, like a bit of paint or something like that. I'm sure I've got some down here. There we go. Let's grab this one right here. Reduce the size of it. That looks pretty good. And then head over to our options, and I just want to angle this kind of like it's coming away, so just like that's pretty good. And then I on the keyboard grabs your selector. We're just going to grab some of these colors that are already on our actual bird. Back to brush. And let's create a new layer for these. And opacity, yep, that's pretty good. Okay, and let's deselect that and stick that on there. Like so. I again select the darker color, back to your brush, stick that in. You can start to see it's just building up over on the right hand side over here. Maybe stick a bit down here. So on, I again grab a bit of the white, back to your brush, maybe increase the size of the brush, stick that there, bring that under the bird. Yep, maybe let's grab another brush. This one here looks pretty good. Let's bring the size down again. Create a new layer. Let's take that in. Bring that under. A little wisp coming off to the side. And that looks pretty good. So, Zed, let's zoom out. Have a look at how that looks. That looks pretty good. Okay, you might want to grab those layers. Maybe just set them to multiply. Just to darken them a little bit coming off the end. Same with this one here. Just, you know, darken them. But I like them like that. It's pretty good. Lower the opacity a bit just to tie them in. And that looks pretty good. Okay, so let's create a new layer at the very top. Okay, so I'm going to apply this image now. With that new layer, I've gone to Image Apply. Click on OK. I'm going to duplicate that image. In fact, I'm going to duplicate the duplicate. I'm going to bring the original right down to where we were looking at our, there we go, move that across, and we're going to come down and we're going to start breaking up this little pillar here, which we didn't do before. Now, to do that, I'm going to select this layer by command clicking on it, coming up to our main image and masking off that area. Now what I can do is grab my lasso tool and we can start to break up. This image. So we can turn off all of these layers. And then with the lasso tool, why is that not working now? Let's have a look. We should only have that image. Why is it? Oh, I know why. Let's turn those off for a second. Okay, and you can see we're slowly breaking up this little area here. Now, just going to undo and make sure we turn those back off and come back down. Okay, so which part do I want? Right, I want to break the top half and this bottom half down here, make it crumble down. So again, just little movements. I know what I'm going to do. This isn't working. Sorry about this. Do apologize. So let's take this applied image, bring it down. I shouldn't have created those other duplicates. Bring it straight down. Above this layer, select our post on this layer, command shift I, inverse the selection, delete the rest, command deselect, and now all we're left with is this actual statue from that layer. So now when I use my lasso tool, A, we can cut things off, but B, they don't disappear into the mask. thing is, be nice and small with these little movements. Okay, looks pretty good. Let's move down. We're going to have some off the side here. Okay, and then this little bit down the bottom. Like so. Much better. Much, much better. Okay. So once we've done that, going to come back all the way up to the top. Again, hit the new layer, image, apply the image again. This time, duplicate that. We're going to go to filter. We're going to go to blur and radial blur. We're going to set that to, I'd say, about 8 pixels, zoom and burst. Click on OK and we get a cool little effect there. Hit the mask down the right hand side, come back to your brush tool. Let's select a big round brush. Okay. And we're going to mask out the important area, which is this area in the middle here, and a little bit like so. So now everything around the sides is out of focus, but the central part is all in focus. So it looks or gives the impression that things are coming in from the side towards this clear area in the middle. Now, unfortunately, I haven't got the Topaz plugin, but you can check that out and follow the last couple of steps. There's only maybe 2 or 3 steps with Topaz. And if you haven't got Lightroom, there's Adobe Lightroom. There's a couple of adjustments to make with Adobe Lightroom to get the color right. And again, there's, you know, lots of different methods to play around with the color. We can hit Command L for our levels, and we can hit Command M, sorry, for our curves, and select the different channels and so on. So let's have a quick play with that. Let's select the blue, bring that up just a bit. Our red, bring that down and along. And then the green, just dip that down. And you start to get a pretty cool, surreal kind of image going on, coming into our main image. Right, so I hope you enjoyed that tutorial. I've been Gavin Steele, taking you through another one of Constantin's brilliant tutorials over at PSD Tuts. Do check them out. Do check some of his other tutorials. They really are brilliant. And check out all of the links. And I'd love to see what you do with yours. So thanks very much. And I hope you enjoyed that.